Alright, back. So, now we have to decide. Because the Seeker Swarms are active here, and Mordin's countermeasure is not powerful enough to repel that many Seekers. It can repel little small swarms of Seeker drones, but not legion of armies of them. So, in order to protect our crew members, we have to create a biotic barrier that is strong enough to protect our squad. And we can select a biotic specialist. And even though Miranda said that any biotic could do it, unfortunately Miranda is not strong enough to do it. There's only two biotics here that are strong enough in their biotic abilities to create that biotic protection field. And that is Samara and Jack. And we're gonna bring Jack.
Jack and I will take a small team through the Seeker Swarm. The rest of you provide a diversion by going through the main passage. We'll open the security doors from the other side and meet you there.
Who should lead the diversion team?
And we are gonna let Miranda lead the diversion team. You can pick Garrus here again if you want to, but I'm gonna pick Miranda.
I'll keep the defenders busy while you slip in the back.
What about me and the rest of the crew, Shepard? We're in no shape to fight.
Commander, we have enough systems back online to do a pickup, but we need to land back from your position.
We can't afford to go back, Shepard. Not now.
If I say mission comes first, the crew that we saved here, they will die. If we want to make sure they survive, we have to send someone to escort them back to Normandy.
I'll send someone with you.
And it doesn't matter. You can send whoever you like with the colonists, as long as you send someone. Sending someone will make sure that they survive. And I'm gonna send Mordin, because Mordin is actually the weakest squad member. And we're gonna send him.
Joker, need location of landing zone. We'll meet you there.
All the squad members have power levels, basically, invisible power levels, and they will be important later on. Alright, so who we are gonna take to the Seeker Swarms? I'm gonna take Garrus, and let's take Syed or Thane. Let's take Thane. Nice. All right, here we go.
Stay close if you want to live.
Of course, if you bring the wrong specialist, a biotic who is not strong enough to hold the field, that squad member will die. So if I had picked Miranda here, Miranda would have probably ended up dying here.
Swarms are interfering with radio contact.
But I'm gonna make sure that everybody survives here.
Let's go, Commander. Incoming.
I want to red.
All right, let's try to warp some of them, and let's. Well, nothing happened there. Well, that's dumb. I want you both switched sniper rifles here. There's gonna be lots of long-range battles in this part, so I wanna make sure that I have snipers. Fuck me. Of course, Jack won't be able to help us because she has to maintain the field. There's one.
We are your genetic destiny.
The fuck? You came to the wrong place, motherfucker.
All clear. Let me know when you're ready to move up, Commander. Ready to move, Commander.
Let's do this. And pick up the base, will you? If I go outside of this pier, I'm gonna take damage from the Seeker Swarms. So, you have to stay inside. As you can see, the Seeker Swarms are trying to get in. Bad spot, Thane. Fuck you, Thane. You were kinda in my way. Fucking bitch. I fucking hate this part of the... hate this part of the mission. Come on, pick up the fucking pace, you little bitch. Jack, or whatever your name is. Move. Move.
Nice shot.
Hostiles, dead ahead.
Dead ahead? Well, they are. There's no more husks? Okay. Fine. Shift fast. Fucking die. And now I have to kill the drones fast, otherwise the Harbinger is gonna possess another drone. Well, he already did. Okay. Fine. Let's kill the... Fuck, I'm in a very bad spot. The Harbinger is gonna close in on us. And I don't have any bullets on my sniper. Either.
This should slow him down.
I have to kill the Harbinger now, otherwise it's gonna kill me. Oh no. Fucking fuck. No, 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 don't let him flank me. Finally.
All clear. Let me know when you're ready to move up, Commander.
Gotta say the get shield saved my life. I actually activated it. I would have probably died if I didn't do it. Let's get some bullets.
I've got no shield.
Oh no, the Seeker Swarms! If I had died there, that would have been pretty funny. And embarrassing at the same time.
Enemy down.
So there's gonna be one more fight, I believe, and then we're done with this segment. Come on, move. Let's get the bullets.
They've seen us.
Right.
I'm taking friendly fire.
No, you're not. What the fuck, Garrison Thane? Oh, the Scion killed them. And I don't want to be killed by the Scion, that's for sure. Alright, time to move. Or not. Was that all the husks? Yes. So all I have to do is now is to kill... Do now is to kill the scion. Hello. Where are you shooting, Shepard? Nice little bug. Look, look! What the fuck? Oh, now it fixed itself. Shit. Die.
All clear. Let me know when you're ready to move up, Commander. Moving out.
That was a strange little bug there. But now we're done. We should be done with this segment. Do
get back in the barrier.
Enemies on our right.
Oh, there's still some husks that we have to kill. No problem. Switch gun.
This isn't working.
Trying to hold on.
So now Jack is starting to struggle all of a sudden. But she will make it. Come on.
Entrance.
Yeah, yeah.
Need to get there.
Pick up the base. All right, now she picked up the base. So good. Where the fuck did that abomination fall into? So through this, and we're done.
Hold on, we're almost there.
So if you picked the wrong squad member, this is the cutscene where the squad member will die. But since we picked Jack, she should be fine.
They're pushing. Keep it up.
Hurry, Shepard.
Boom. And everything went better than expected.
Repeat. Shepard, do you copy?
I copy. What's your position?
We're at the door. They've got us pinned down.
Now, of course, if you pick the wrong squad leader for the other team, that member is gonna die as well.
Come on.
But since we picked Miranda, she should be fine. What the fuck happened there?
Ready for action, Commander.
That was strange.
Joker, are you at the rendezvous point?
I'm here, Commander.
There was a weird transition in the cutscene. I don't know if you noticed that.
No casualties.
Excellent. Now let's make it count.
All right.
What's our next step?
There should be some nearby platforms that will take you to the main control console. From there, you can overload the system and destroy the base.
All right.
You got a problem. Hostiles massing just outside the door. Won't be long till I bust through.
So it looks like Mordin managed to escort the other crew members, we saved back to Normandy. Surprise. It doesn't matter who you pick to escort, then they will always be successful. All right, so here's an important thing. If you pick We'd Better Hurry, there's going to be a 10-minute time limit to destroy the base. Now, if you pick someone has to hold this door, then the rest of your squad mates will hold this door and you will have unlimited time limit. But if you don't have enough squad power, and what I mean by that is when I said that every squad member has a hidden power level, the remaining squad members that you leave here, they will defend this position, and their individual power levels will add up into defensive points, and that will determine whether they survive the defending or not. And since if it happens so, that you lose your squad members during this mission, picking the wrong specialist, or you had it upgraded your Normandy, you might be left with a very, very few squad members here, and that doesn't give you enough power levels. So those squad members that will stay here to defend, if there's two left or something, one or two left, they will die for sure. So you want to make sure that. And that's why I sent Mordin away, because Mordin is the weakest squad member. He has the weakest individual power level, so that's the why I sent him off. And we have plenty of power level anyway, so it doesn't really matter who we send off, because we kept everyone alive. So we can easily hold this position, and I will have plenty of time to do what we set out to do here.
Defend this position and keep the collectors from overwhelming us.
Pick a team to go with you, Shepard. Everyone else can bunker down here and cover your back.
So now we have to pick a team who will come with us. I'm gonna take Miranda. And I'm gonna take Jay. Should I take Garrus? Garrus or Jake? Well, Garrus or Jacob? Well, let's take Jacob. Here we go. One last speech, and we're off.
I'm ready, Commander.
So am I.
Anything to say before we do this?
The Collectors, the Reapers, they aren't a threat to us. They're a threat to everything, everyone. Those are the lives we're fighting for. That's the scale. It's been a long journey, and no one's coming out without scars. But it all comes down to this moment. We win or lose it all in the next few minutes. Make me proud. Make yourselves proud.
Well said. Let's go finish this.
Nice.
Enemies incoming!
I kinda need more ammo.
Enemies incoming.
Nice. Fucking Harbinger. I was just about to kill that son of a bitch. Oh, there's an assassin. I'm gonna kill it. Kill the assassin! Assassin! Oh snap. There it went. Oh, looks like Miranda. Well, Jacob is dead. Let's get Jacob up. The collector assassin is still alive. Let's pull him. No! The fucking Harbinger possessed that guy. Let's kill it. Let's use a shotgun so I can get rid of the barrier faster. Nice. Bullets. Nice. I'm gonna activate the get shield. So there's gonna be two Scions and a couple of Abominations, nothing special.
Target down.
Right, this should be easy. Pew 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 pew. Oh shit. What the? Okay. That was strange. Well, the warp didn't do shit. I kinda need my shields back. Where are they? Or my HP back. I have max shields, but my HP was low. Pew 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 pew. That's the last of them. Is there any bullets that I can loot? Not really. Fine.
This is it. All the tubes lead to this spot.
So now we're gonna rig the place to explode.
What are they doing?
The tubes are feeding into some kind of superstructure. It is emitting both organic and non-organic energy signatures. Given these readings, it must be massive. Shepard, if my calculations are correct, the superstructure is a Reaper.
Not just any Reaper. A human Reaper.
Precisely.
So yeah, the collectors were building a really Reaper here. Made out of human cells.
It appears the collectors have processed.
That's why they... Yeah, that's why they abducted humans. They abducted humans and melted them into some sort of liquid, and now they're pumping it into that Reaper.
What did the collectors gain by turning humans into this Reaper shell?
They may be facilitating
a Reaper, that's what they gain.
Collectors are just Protheans. Why would they help the Reapers?
The Reapers subdued the Protheans long ago. Probabilities suggest they attempted to create a Prothean Reaper and failed. Over time, they adapted the Protheans to suit their needs, changed them, turned them into workers, tools for the Reapers.
They're building it to look like a human. Why?
It appears that a Reaper's shape is based upon the species used to create it.
Reapers are machines. Why do they need humans at all?
Incorrect. Reapers are sapient constructs, a hybrid of organic and inorganic material. The exact construction methods are unclear, but it seems probable that the Reapers absorb the essence of a species, utilizing it in their reproduction process.
How many more humans do you think they'd try to take?
Millions. Perhaps more. Impossible to know for certain. This Reaper appears to be in a very early stage of development.
So it's not alive yet? We can still stop it from being created?
The process can be stopped, but it is unclear exactly how much it has developed. I cannot, for example, tell you if it has awareness.
This thing is an abomination. Edie, how do we destroy it?
The large tubes injecting the fluid are a weak structural link. Destroying them should cause the supports to collapse, and the Reaper to fall.
Give us a minute, Edie.
Alright, so now we have to make sure that...
Enemies incoming!
...that the collectors won't be able to build that thing. So we are gonna destroy it. Of course there's gonna be some stupid collectors that are gonna slow us down. Fucking fuck, man. Die, you piece of shit harbinger. I know that collector over there.
This delay is pointless.
Die. Nice. Now I should be able to destroy the weak points. So I can destroy all four of them with the adrenaline rush if I'm fast enough. Nice. And we beat it. We did it. Without adrenaline rush, you will most likely be able to destroy one or two dupes per wave, per collector wave. But since I, with adrenaline rush and the machine gun, I was able to destroy all four of them in one collector wave. A quick exit is preferable. So I saved us a lot of time.
Enter the Normandy. Joker, prep the engines. I'm about to overload this place and blow it sky high.
Roger that, Commander. Commander, I've got an incoming signal from the Elusive Man. He's patching it through.
Alright, Elusive Man has something to say.
Shepard, you've done the impossible.
I'm not finished here yet. This base is 10 minutes from extinction.
Wait. I have a better option. I'm looking at the schematics Edie uploaded. A timed radiation pulse would kill the remaining collectors, but leave the machinery and technology intact. This is our chance, Shepard. They were building a Reaper. That knowledge, that framework could save us.
So basically what the Elusive Man wants, he wants us to use a radiation pulse to kill the collectors, and then Elusive Man would use this place to do whatever he pleases to do with it.
It liquefied people, turned them into something horrible. We have to destroy the base.
Don't be short-sighted. Our best chance against the Reapers is to turn their own resources against them.
I'm not so sure. Seeing it firsthand, using anything from this base seems like a betrayal.
If we ignore this opportunity, that would be a betrayal. They were working directly with the collectors. Who knows what information is buried there? This base is a gift. We can't just destroy it.
You're completely ruthless. The next thing I know, you'll be wanting to grow your own Reaper.
My goal is to save humanity from the Reapers, at any cost. I've never hidden that from you. Imagine how many lives could be saved if we keep this base intact and use its knowledge to thwart the Reapers. Imagine the lives that will be lost if we don't.
No matter what kind of technology we might find, it's not worth it.
Shepard, you died fighting for what you believed. I brought you back so you could keep fighting. Some would say what we did to you was going too far, but look what you've accomplished. I didn't discard you because I knew your value. Don't be so quick to discard this facility. Think of the potential.
So there's gonna be a decision here. We can destroy the base, or we can use the radiation pulse to kill the remaining collectors and keep the base for our own and use it against the Reapers. Of course, Elusive Man makes a good point. It's the logical decision. But we wanna make sure that nobody will ever use this base to malicious intents ever again. So let's destroy it.
We'll fight and win without it. I won't let fear compromise who I am.
Miranda, do not let Shepard destroy the base.
Or what? You'll replace me next?
I gave you an order, Miranda.
I noticed. Consider this my resignation.
And obviously, Shepard, Elusive Man is gonna be pissed.
About everything Cerberus has done for you. You...
Let's move. We've got 10 minutes before the reactor overloads and blows this whole station apart.
10 minutes, you say? Alright, so now looks like the Reaper actually was alive. Somewhat alive. And now we have to destroy it by shooting at the weak points. The eyes and that little core in the chest is a weak point as well. And one shot from the McCain heavy weapon is enough to destroy the Reaper. But it is incredibly hard to hit. To actually hit the Reaper with the heavy weapon. Because it constantly keeps moving around, so actually hitting with that heavy weapon is gonna be very tough. I'm actually running out of ammo, so I have to get some. Of course, the Reaper isn't enough for us, they also have to attack us with some collector drones. Because what the fuck not. The Reaper is gonna destroy this platform slowly, one at a time. All except the middle platform, so we wanna make sure that I won't be standing in any of the platforms when he destroys one. I need more weapons. Weapon ammo, I mean. There's one. Why is there more? No, there isn't, but let's damage this guy. Unfortunately, your squad members aren't good enough so that they can actually hit the target. Oh, goddammit. More bullets. Fucking Harbinger. There goes one platform.
I know you feel this.
Is there any...
This hurts you.
Hurts what? My ass?
If I must tear you apart, Shepard, I will.
Alright, that's gone. Focus on the weak points again. What the? Oh shit. We're starting to run out of cover here. And I'm starting to run out of bullets too. Where's one? There's some. Nice, is there more?
Nothing's gonna hurt me now.
The Reaper's over there. Fine. Let's get the fuck out of this platform. We should be done almost. Couple more hits. Nice, there it is. And we did it. Killed the human Reaper. No. Why is the music so silent? Boom. Why is the audio so low? Alright, nobody died. Of course, if your squad members aren't loyal here, they will both end up dying. At this part.
Do you copy? Commander! Come on, Shepard, don't leave me hanging, do you copy?
I'm here, Joker. Did the ground team make it?
Survivors on board, we're just waiting for you.
Human, you've changed nothing. Your species has the attention of those infinitely or greater. That which you know as Reapers are your
get the gist of it, Edie. Hold on!
Nice. And that's the suicide mission. And that's the end of the game, basically. There's gonna be one final cutscene. Short cutscene. And then it's gonna... then they're gonna roll the credits. Basically. But first, a little chat with the elusive man.
Shepard. You're making a habit of costing me more than time and money.
Too many lives were lost at that base. I'm not sorry it's gone.
The first of many lives. The technology from that base could have secured human dominance in the galaxy, against the Reapers and beyond.
Human dominance? Or just Cerberus?
Strength for Cerberus is strength for every human. Cerberus is humanity. I should have known you'd choke on the hard decisions, too idealistic from the start.
I know what you are, and the price of dealing with you. We do things my way from now on. Harbinger is coming, and he won't be alone. I'm gonna make sure we're ready when they get here. You can fall in line or step aside, but don't get in my way.
You're sure that's what you want? You're taking a hell of a risk, Shepard.
Joker, lose this chin.
And now... we said farewell to Elusive Man and his Cerberus. Fuck this guy. And obviously, Elusive Man is gonna be pretty pissed that we dumped him like this. Nice, that's the end of the game, and, but, it is not end of Mass Effect 2, we still have, surprise surprise, we still have one more mission left, and I saved it to be the very last mission, because, and I will explain it once I get back to Normandy, there's gonna be the game is gonna continue after the final mission, and we have, what is this, why is this still here? Why is this still here? Alright, fuck it anyway. So basically what I saved last, I saved the Arrival DLC last, because canonically this DLC actually takes place after the suicide mission. And it will make more sense in Mass Effect 3 if we finish this mission after the suicide mission. It will just make more sense to do it now. So yeah, this is not the end of Mass Effect 2. We are, however, done with the main storyline, but no way are we done with Mass Effect 2. We still have that downloadable content, and I will be finishing that in this session as well, because why the fuck not? So let's check out the timer. Okay, it's gonna be, well, it's been quite a while. So whatever, I'm gonna save the footage here, and see you next time.